What's up, everybody? It's Danny.
And it's Hunter.
And we are here today. We're going to try to do a video on how to become a YouTuber. We know that starting a channel is kind of hard, so we just wanted to give you some pointers.
That's right, you guys. YouTube isn't easy. And let me tell you something. We ourselves have been working on it. It's definitely a day-to-day process, but being in YouTube, it's fun, man. You just got to have some fun. We got some tips to give you guys to help you help us help each other.
Yeah. So you guys, I have my phone right here. I wrote down a couple of notes and stuff like that. So the first one I have is you can start at any age.
Any age. And when we say any age, we're not talking about like even your infant can be a YouTube channel sensation. Like babies are on YouTube. There's babies, there's dogs, there's inanimate objects. Anything that can be YouTube is not limited to just older people, limited to all kids, children, all of that. So
that's yeah.
Personal. Number two.
Number two. Now, when you start a YouTube channel, you need to post at least twice a week.
Twice a week. Now, the reason why we say twice a week is because the more you post, the more people get to see. Now, we understand, now don't get me wrong, this is a job. This is not something that's easy, guys. This is definitely a job. And if you're not committed to pushing the videos, it is going to be difficult. Even us two together with just two of us, we still find it difficult to get videos out on time. But what we're saying is, guys, it's definitely a process, but it's not something that you can't do. It all depends on how you want to do it.
You got to have a positive mindset with everything that you're doing. Okay, now, a trick that I found out with the YouTube algorithm.
I'm going to have algorithm description below.
A trick that I found out, whenever you make a video, try to make videos to searchable stuff that's already out. So say, for instance, something that's hot right now, TikTok. You can do TikTok reaction videos.
Yeah. TikTok reaction videos. TikTok is a growing thing right now. As we can see, everybody is on TikTok. Use those. It's always good information and good ideas you can pull from TikTok using those platforms, and they can also help your platform grow as well.
So if you're good at like makeup, good at doing hair, you're good at, I also saw the other day, I like to clean. I seen people cleaning houses, cleaning room, organizing, like DIY projects. Like anything that you see that's when you're typing in, it's a searchable term, make a video on that because people are looking it up. So that's one way to push your videos out.
And don't make it, what we mean by that is like, don't put a name that you know nobody's going to find out. Like, don't be like,
you need to be found.
Yeah, so if you want to be seen or you want your stuff to be found, put something that is relatable to the community that you're trying to reach.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so if you're doing jokes, have something to say, laugh out loud, LMAO, something that helps people find you when you get on the internet.
Now, the next one is...
What number are we on? Was that three?
That was three. We're on number...
Number four.
Four. Finding your niche. Now, we were just talking about that. Do something that you're very good at.
Mm-hmm.
If you're good at cleaning, if you're good at hair, if you're good at nails, even if you want to promote your business, do something that you're good at so that you can post a lot.
What we mean by that is, fellas, you love game? I'm a gamer. I love games. You see PewDiePie on the internet. Even if you love games, that can be your niche. Anything that you feel comfortable with, make it into your own thing. I play games. I'm on Twitch. I play games. I talk to people. And I still do what I love to do by still enjoying what I like to do without having to change who I am. So people are not shocked like, oh, he just started playing games. No, I love playing games. But you have to do something that you feel comfortable with.
Anything. It could be a subject. It could be an action. If you love math, you can do math. You can do math problems and stuff like people will look that up.
Some people don't know no math.
Teaching how to make wigs, how to do nails, how to do just so much stuff. Like, I feel like YouTube is a place where people love to go do things. Like, say, for instance, we had to fix our car. We had to change our PCV valve. I typed it in on YouTube, and we found out how to do it. And mind you, our dealership wanted to charge us, $3-something? And we paid $20 to fix it ourselves. So YouTube is that place. If you have something online and that you want to do, you do it.
Exactly. So number five.
Number five. Did we already say create a schedule?
No, that's right now.
No.
We didn't say that yet.
Yes, we did. We said that already.
We're experiencing technical difficulties.
All right, number five, don't stress over your growth. Now, right now, our channel is probably like at 30 subscribers. My personal channel is probably like at 100 subscribers or whatever. Don't stress. I'm telling you, it's going to mess with your head. Just keep posting. Just keep posting. You have to be very consistent.
Consistency.
The YouTube program is not going to push you out unless you're posting up videos. YouTube is basically watch time, and that's what you need to do. Mm-hmm. Create entertaining videos or instructional videos or just something that's worthwhile learning that people will love to look at, you know?
Exactly. Yeah, so just and what she means by that in just the regular sense is more like, don't take it. I understand, yes, it's a job, but to stress yourself out about it is not what you need to do.
You should have fun with it.
Exactly. Do it. YouTube should be, posting a YouTube video should be something that you do because it's fun, not because something that you're obligated to do and you're like, oh, my life. No, just do it because it's fun. And hey, you want to share something with, that's what YouTube is, to share what you have with the rest of the world. That's what it is. It's just a platform for you to show what you can do. Maybe you might be talented and nobody would know. But you post that on the internet, but don't stress yourself. It ain't gonna grow overnight. It definitely doesn't grow overnight. We've had YouTube how long?
Since October.
Since October, and we're slowly growing, but we have learned that it's definitely gonna take some time. But consistency is key.
Okay, the next tip. If you need to record, you don't need any fancy camera or anything. When I first started, I bought a camera in a vlogging kit, and it was just like I use my phone more to video and to edit. So that's the next tip. The next tip is use your iPhone for beginners,
or Android if you have Android.
Yeah, for iPhone users, I don't know about Android, but for iPhone users, there's an app on your phone called iMovie. It is the perfect editing tool that I use. It helps me out a lot. For people who do on Android, I know you could probably use Final Cut Pro. There's Filmora 9.
Yeah, Filmora 9.
Those you can use on your computers and stuff like that. So that's one thing you can do for that. Also, I feel like iPhone or Android, for iPhone or Android, I say just record on your device versus buying a camera. Mm-hmm. When you get to that point and you're making money, that's when I say, you know, invest. It's a process. You starting from the bottom, and then now you're here. Period. The next tip.
I like what you said there. Started from the bottom, now we're here. I'm going to start dancing. Started from the bottom.
The next tip, y'all.
Number 7.
Create thumbnails that pop. You have to.
And we will have a YouTube video on that to show you how to create thumbnails. We created thumbnails on our page. As you can see, if you go to her page, you can see the thumbnail that she has. Anything that you want to do can be your thumbnail. Mind you, this is your thumbnail. These are pictures that you make it what you wanted to do. That's just the big thing about YouTube.
Okay, so for the people who don't know what a thumbnail is the first picture on your video that people are going to see. Now, when you post your video up, they're not going to see the whole video going. They're going to see something, and you need that whole picture, the thumbnail of your video, to, you know, capture the minds or to catch someone's attention and be like, ooh, let me click on this and watch what this person is doing. So thumbnails are very, 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 very important. If you're on your phone, you can use either PixArt or Fonto to create your thumbnails. Babe does our thumbnails on Babe does our thumbnails on the computer. What thing do you use?
That's nice.
Come on, bro.
All right. I use the Canvas app. Mind you, it is free, you guys, to download onto your phone and download it onto a computer. All you got to do is just go to canvas.com. And you can go ahead and give you ideas. It gives you exactly what you need for thumbnails. all your interesting needs. You can upload pictures, post them, backgrounds, the entire thing, you guys. Again, Canvas is the way to go. I do thumbnails for us. We have some thumbnails with it looks crazy, but you want something that's gonna catch the people's attention as soon as they type in something. Like, how many times you go on YouTube and you type in something and stuff?
A lot. Okay, you guys. So the next step is learning to get monetized. Now, in order for you to even start getting paid from YouTube, you have to have, well, I know right now they haven't updated the stuff as yet, the requirements. It's 1,000 subscribers and it's 4,000, it's 4,000 public hours. Once you pass 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 public watch hours, that's when they will email you and tell you you're eligible to join the YouTube program so that you can start getting paid. Now, also with that, you would also have to sign up for Google AdSense. That's how YouTubers get paid.
What is it basically for? What does it do?
So Google AdSense is basically ads being placed on your YouTube videos. You're getting paid for the ads. So now say if someone watches the whole ad, you get paid for that. And I think they can either do before and after ads, and then I don't know, you get paid for ads. I gotta do a deeper thing to let y'all know, but I know for a fact for you to even get paid, you have to have a Google AdSense account.
Okay.
And that's how you get paid. Most YouTubers, what they don't tell you is many of them get paid through sponsorship.
Right.
Their checks be bigger from brands that come to them that want to sponsor them, and that's how they're getting paid, through sponsorships. So even though they're getting that check from Google AdSense, they're also getting another check from sponsors and brands who sponsor them. All right.
Good. So what number we at? 10?
I don't even know what number we're at.
10.
The next tip, make sure your videos is over 10 minutes. And the reason why I say that is because the longer your videos, when you do reach monetization, when it comes to ads, you can have probably like 4 to 5 ads in your video, and people have to watch that because they want to see and continue on with your video, and you're getting paid for that. So I say 10 minutes or more. It's kind of cool.
10 minutes. Guys, videos don't have to be 24 hours. Even if it's just a short bit, 10 minutes, 5 minutes the less, the least? 5 minutes the less, the least. Crazy. What's the next
tip? You said 5 minutes. 5 minutes
the less. 5 minutes the less. Wait.
I say 10 minutes, you guys. I say 10 minutes. If you want to do like, I know YouTube right now has short videos. You can do those. Those are also kind of cool. But short videos doesn't go towards your monetization. So even on short videos, will pick up on views like it has done on my channel. It picks up on views. But YouTube program doesn't count that as monetization. So I was hyped for no reason. The next thing you have to...
Number 11.
The next thing you have to figure out with YouTube, no one teaches you about taxes. Now, when you join the YouTube program, you're basically your own person. You're self-employed. So you would have to look up the 1099 forms for taxes. So anytime you're getting paid from YouTube, that's the next step. So write that down. 1099 forms. You're doing your own taxes. They're not going to tax you. You have to do your own taxes. And you better do it right because the IRS surely will come for that behind. Okay?
For your keister.
The next tip.
Number 12.
Who cares what they think about your videos?
No one cares.
If you love what you do, then do it.
Basically, that's just like what she said. If you love what you do, just do it, you guys. Don't be afraid to do what you do. Be as normal as you possibly can. Because that's what people want, is honesty. People can tell when you're not being who you are.
Yeah, I hate fake individuals. It's not cute at all.
Like, hey, what up, guys? And bap, bap, bap. You know, if you're just a calm person, hey, good morning, you guys. What's going on?
Just be your original self. Just be you. I love it.
And
Look, you can subscribe to our channel, and I surely will subscribe, and I'll be the main person watching your stuff. And truly and honestly.
Look at us. We're polar opposites. She's more the quiet one. I'm more the excited one, but we love, that's what makes it our videos. Nobody can tell us anything. We love what we do, and we just want to show it to you.
And we got two more tips. The second to last tip is get used to talking to the camera. Now, we'll sit here and we'll just be practicing and stuff like that. You always have to, you know, I feel like just use it as a mirror, to be honest. When you're talking and stuff, just practice. I know me personally, I speak really fast, so I mumble over my words, which he pointed out earlier in the video. But just, you know, practice. Practice makes perfect.
She just did it. August, that was you?
No, I stepped on his toy.
Woke him up. Again, you guys, it's all fun. It's just great, you guys. Just do it because you love doing it, not because you're trying to see the. Think of the end goal when it get there. But in the meantime, worry about the goal in front of you, and that's just doing what you do.
And then the last tip.
Oh, last one.
I know y'all see the lighting. It's actually bright. I'm going to, I wish we had a better one, but, you can go on Amazon, you can type in vlogging kit, basically, or even Best Buy has it. It's basically a tripod with the lighting on the top. The vlogging kit for all of this, I think it was $80.
Money.
But there's cheaper ones on Amazon. Mm-hmm. Very cheap. Trust and believe, because this $80, I was kind of like, eh. But this vlogging kit came with a self microphone. It came with the lighting. It came with other devices and stuff like that. But you need a tripod with lighting on it. So whenever you're doing your videos, you know, you can see more clearer. We have a light on right now. Y'all wouldn't even know.
We just glowing. What if people didn't even know that?
We have on two lights right now, and I still feel like there's not that much light. I feel like we need more light at different angles.
I think we need to get one for right here and have a whole row of lights in front of us. Like, lights, camera!
So, it's so much stuff you're going to need for YouTube, but I believe in you. We believe in you. And I just say start it.
Yes, man.
If anybody says don't do it, that should make you do it even more. You know? So, you guys, we will do a part two for how to grow your YouTube channel. But we just wanted to give you some basic tips on how to create your YouTube channel. And if you like what we said, if you like our content, please subscribe, you guys. Please like, please comment if you want to know anything or if you want to ask any questions. We are always here. Just let us know what's going on.
That's right, you guys. Like she said, we are always going to be here. We love you guys. Be blessed. Have a great day.
Later, y'all.
Peace.